Welcome class to another unit, and in this unit we are going to cover the importance of corn in Mesoamerica. I know that you are learning about what is Mesoamerica. So Mesoamerica is a vast region that encompasses many countries. It's not really Central America, but most of the countries in Central America are part of Mesoamerica. So we start with Southern Mexico, Guatemala, we have Honduras, we have Nicaragua, we have Belize, parts of El Salvador, and maybe a little bit of Costa Rica. And that vast region is considered to be Mesoamerica. And that is the home of the main civilizations that we are going to cover in this class. And because I'm going to concentrate with agriculture, and corn happens to be the core, the center of how Mesoamerican culture thrives based on corn. And it deals with the discussion question that you have for the week: how has Mesoamerican cuisine influenced the diet of people living in the U.S.? And really, when you go to a party or any event, you notice that in the table there are chips and guacamole. We go to the movie theaters, you buy popcorn. So there's a wide range of Mexican restaurants throughout the U.S. From, you might want to see it as fake Mexican food, Taco Bell, Rambertos, Roberto's, Los Panchos. If you live here in San Diego, then you probably think that Tacos El Gordo is amazing. But those of us who live in the U.S., from California to Texas, and that is the Southwest, it is a part of our regular diet. Mexican food is not really exotic like Indian food, because people are used to our cuisine. It's something that have been here since the beginning of time. Let's go back in time to trace the development of these delicious food dishes. How do we know what and how ancient people ate? Fortunately, in Mesoamerica, we have several lines of evidence. First, we rely on the documents written by the early Spanish conquistadores. It provides a good source of information into the custom of early Mesoamerican civilizations. And the second is done through archaeology, that provides a second line of evidence for reconstructing the food ways. Your book talks about the importance of the three sister crops, also known as the American Trinity. Native Americans called it the three inseparable sisters. They were corn, beans, and squash. They were planted together because these three plants nutritionally complemented each other during growth. The beans would grow as a vine using the stalk of the corn, and the squash spread around the ground, preventing any weed from growing. These three plants were crucial in the development of permanent settlements and the development of civilization of Mesoamerica. The region known as Mesoamerica, especially in the highlands of Mexico and Guatemala, is one of the four or five primary centers of plant domestication in the world. I am going to mention some of the products that come out of corn, and I'm sure you probably have seen some of this, and maybe you haven't, but for example, in food products, there are tortillas, cereals, snack foods, salad dressing, soft drinks, chewing gum, popcorn, and many other items, and I don't have time to go over all of them. And I'm going to give you another small sample. In industrial products, there are soaps, paintings, linoleum, polish, dry cell batteries, textiles, and so many other items that we find that comes out of corn. And because corn is so important, the U.S., believe it or not, produces 40% of the world's corn supplies and accounts for more than half of the world corn exports. That's crazy. Aside from the nutritional value of corn also had a tremendous impact in the myths and legends that were a part of the Mesoamerican religion. When women gave birth, the umbilical cord was cut over a maize cup. When someone died, the Mayas placed a small piece of maize dough in the mouth. The idea was that corn would give them energy to travel to the underworld. This underworld for the Mayas was known as Xibalba. And even according to the Pozole book, that was the Bible of the Maya, humans were made from maize dough. These stories are similar throughout Mesoamerica. This vast region was a place of constant interaction between cultures and people. Most scientists believe that corn evolved about 9,000 years ago in the Valley of Mexico. It came out of a plant called teosinte, and of course teosinte doesn't even look like anything like the corn that is being produced today. Most of the corn that you eat, 99% of it, is called yellow dent number 2, and it is the corn that you buy at your local store or even the popcorn that you eat at the movie theater. The way maize was prepared, it was a process called nixtamalization. The ripe maize grains were first soaked and then boiled in lime water mixed with boron and ground limestone or ash. After boiling, the maize kernels were ground to on a metate. A metate was a flat grinding stone, and this resulted in a dough. Dough in Spanish called masa, and this masa later was turned into a flat bread, and that we all know as tortillas. And then combining these tortillas with bean, there you have it. You have a complete nutritional package. So with dough of the corn, Mesoamericans also made tamales. And if you haven't had a tamale is a dough, and inside of this dough, back in those days, Mesoamericans would put dogs, they would put shrimp, they would put even mosquito larvas. But really the word tamale means food that is being wrapped. And that's something that Mesoamericans have been eating for as long as 2,000 years ago. There's also another famous soup or boiled broth that is known as pozole. Yes, you probably know it if you happen to be Mexicanos, pozole. But back in those days, the Aztecs, they will boil these kernels in water, and not just any maize kernels, but hominy, which is a type of kernel. Pozole or pozole was a term to describe many dishes in Mesoamerica, both in Central Mexico and Yucatan. Today we know it as pozole, and it's really a soup with hominy and pork in it. It's really good and delicious. Also, out of corn, they created their alcohol beverage, and it was called Balche. And they sort of messed it up with different fruits and spices. And this fermented drink were quite common throughout Mesoamerican and quite intoxicating as well. I was mentioning at the beginning of this audio podcast how every time that you go to a fiesta, a party, or there is a venue or festivity, you see in the table chips with guacamole. And now guacamole is something that is really important because we can also trace it back to about 7,000 years ago. Mesoamericans used the ripe avocado and turned it into a sauce called agua moli, meaning avocado mixture. The word avocado comes from the ancient Aztec word aguacato, meaning human testicles. As you can see, Mesoamericans had a wide variety of vegetables, being corn the main one, and they would combine tortillas with everything they had around them, from tomatoes, avocados, chiles, squash, you name it. It was so rich that by the time the Europeans came, they ended up adding those products into their diet. And that is something known as the Colombian exchange. What Europeans took to Europe and also what Europeans brought to the New World, giving sort of like a new hybrid cuisine that we have today. I hope you enjoyed this audio podcast, and I'm looking forward to the next.